Assalamualaikum and good morning. I am your social studies teacher and this explanation is for grade 5. Before starting the lecture, I will tell you the name of the book and chapter's name. The name of the book is Paramount Social Studies Book 5 and the name of the chapter is Landform. Before starting the explanation, I want to inform you that this chapter is too lengthy. So, in this video, I am going to explain some kind of landform. Let's start. What are landforms? The physical feature of the earth is called landforms. Example: hill, mountains, valley, lake, seas, etc. These are kind of landforms. Let's talk about them in detail. The first kind in your textbook is fold mountains. Before starting the explanation of fold mountain, you have to understand the meaning of earth crust. Earth crust is the outer or first layer of the earth. That layer forms land and oceanic floor. Now coming back towards the mountain. Mountain holds and fixes the crust of the earth. These crust move like a cloud. But we don't feel the movement of the earth's crust because the movement is too slow. Earth crust is moving constantly. That movement is called crustal movement. Now fold mountains are formed due to crustal movements. That movements also give rise to the volcanoes and mountains. The folded sedimentary rock are formed the peak of Himalayas and Alps in Europe. Now what are sedimentary rocks? Sedimentary rocks mean the rock which settle at the bottom of a liquid. For example, take a glass of water, put some stone in it, then the stone settle down. That settled down material is called sedimentary rock. Let's take a quick review of fold mountain. When two surfaces move toward each other due to crustal movement, the sedimentary rock pushed up and form fold mountains. The next landform is cliff. What are cliffs? Cliffs are high, steep, means downward, faces of rocks. They are found close by the seashore and mountainous area. They are formed due to erosion and weathering. Now what is weathering? Weathering is the process by which large rocks are broken up over a long period of time into smaller and smaller pieces. Erosion means wearing away of rock which has been broken up by the weathering. So, the cliffs are formed due to erosion and weathering. Softer rock disappear due to wind or water flow. Those rocks which are hard and unaffectable by erosion and weathering forms cliff. The famous cliffs are Llan in England and Moher in Ireland. The highest cliffs in the world are Nanga Parbat's Rupal flank, the Great Tarango in Karakoram Mountains, and the Kalaupapa in Hawaii. Now let's take a quick review of cliffs. Cliffs are high steep face of rock that are formed due to erosion and weathering. Now our next kind of landform is our bays. Now what are bays? The body surrounded by the land is called bay. Bays are formed by the erosion of rock. Bays connect to another water body. The water is calm and ideal for fishing. A large bay is called gulf. Now what is the difference between bay and gulf? Gulf is larger than bay and it is deeper than bay, but gulf has narrow opening. Gulf has narrow opening than bay, and bay has wider opening. As you can see that bay has wider opening. See, the bay connects the Bay of Bengal connects the Indian Ocean. Bay of Bengal connects the Indian connects with the Indian Ocean. So bay has wider opening. Or gulf has narrow opening. Alright. The world largest bay is called Bay of Bengal, and the world largest gulf is called Gulf of Mexico and the Persian Gulf. Now next is peninsulas. What do you mean by peninsulas? Peninsulas means almost an island. Peninsulas are the landforms which are surrounded by water on three sides. Peninsulas are attached to a much larger piece of land. Can you see that the three parts of peninsulas are covered with water? These are the three parts. Only one part is covered with land. Some prominent peninsulas are Malaysian and Italian peninsulas. So this is the picture of peninsula, and you can see that three parts are covered with water, only one part is covered with land. Valleys. The lowland area between hills and mountains are called valleys. The lowland area between hills and mountains are called valleys. These areas are fertile. River flows through valley. Now what is rift valley? When two parallel parts of the earth move and land masses sink in the middle, it is called rift valley. In other words, You can see that two parallel, these are the parallel part of the earth. These are the parallel part of the earth, and the land mass sink in the middle. It's going down. It's going down. This is how Rift Valley formed. I hope you understand. These kind of landform. So, the other kind of landform I will explain in the other video. Now, in the next slide, in this slide, you can see that meanings of difficult words. The words which are difficult, I have given the meaning of those words just for your convenience. And then homework, the last slide, homework. What you have to do? You have to answer these questions. What are landforms? What are bays? Name two prominent peninsulas. And please read the chapter carefully. It will be easy for you to do these, to find out these answers if you read the chapter. Please read the chapter carefully. Thank you so much.